Today we are going to start revision number 2 of chapter number 8, quadrilaterals. So now we are going to complete the left out questions of exercise 8.1. पिछले revision में हम लोग 5th question तक किए थे, right? So this is revision number 2. So let us start with the question number 6. Diagonal AC of parallelogram ABCD bisects angle A. Show that it bisects angle C also. And ABCD is a rhombus. Okay, so let us start with AB is parallel to DC. Ye dono parallel hai. Okay, and ek minute. Isko pehle naam likh lete hain angles ka. 1, 2, 3, 4. Right. It is given that diagonal AC bisects angle A. So angle 1 is equals to angle 2. Right. Clear hai?
Yes sir.
But what is given? ABCD is a parallelogram. So can we say that angle 1 is equals to angle 3?
Yes sir.
Why?
Yes sir.
Alternate interior angle.
Very good. Similarly, angle 2 is equals to angle 3. Okay. But angle 1 is equals to angle 2. Why?
Given.
Yes. AC bisects angle A. Right? So therefore it will implies angle 3 is also equals to angle 4. Why? Because angle 1 is equals to angle 3, angle 2 is equals to angle 4, and angle 1 is equals to angle 2 will imply angle 3 is equals to angle 4. Thus AC bisects angle C also. So first bit is over. Now we have to show that ABCD is a rhombus. So rhombus ke liye hum log start kar rahe hain. Sabse pehle angle 1 is equals to angle 3. ऑलरेडी प्रूफ किया है यहां पर, ओके, एंड एंगल 1 इज आल्सो इक्वल्स टू एंगल 2, सो कैन वी से दैट एंगल 2 इज इक्वल्स टू एंगल 3, राइट? एंगल 1 इज इक्वल्स टू एंगल 3 एंड एंगल 1 इज इक्वल्स टू एंगल 2 विल इंप्लाई एंगल 2 एंड एंगल 3 आर इक्वल. नाउ इफ दीस टू एंगल्स आर इक्वल, ए बी इज इक्वल्स टू बी सी. व्हाई?
Opposite to equal
angles are equal. Yes, angles opposite to equal sides, sides opposite to equal angles are equal. Right? Now, AB and DC are equal and AD and BC are equal. Why? Opposite sides of parallelogram. Right. Now, AB or BC dono equal hai. So, that means all sides are equal. Hence, ABCD is a rhombus. Any doubt in this question?
No, sir.
Okay. Now, the seventh question. ABCD is a rhombus. Show that diagonal AC bisects angle A as well as angle C. Right? And diagonal BD bisects angle B as well as angle D. So, sabse pehle, ye dono ko proof kar rahe hain hum log. Angle 1 is equals to angle 2. Why? Because AB is equals to BC. Why AB is equals to BC? Sides of rhombus are equal. So that will imply angle 1 is equals to angle 2. Why?
Angles opposite to equal sides are equal.
Very good. Angles opposite to equal sides are equal. And 1 is also equals to 3.
Alternate interior
angles. Very good. Alternate interior angles. So from this two, we can conclude that angle 2 and angle 3 are equal. Okay. So that means AC bisects angle C. Now we have to show that it bisects angle A also. Uske liye kaise karenge dekho. Angle 2 and angle 4 are equal. Angle 2 and angle 4 are equal. Why?
Alternate interior.
Right. Alternate interior angles. And 2 kiske barabar hai?
One
के बराबर है. So in place of 2, we can write 1. Now these two angles are equal. So therefore, AC bisects angle A. So first part is over. Now we have to show for BD. So जैसे हम लोग AC का proof किए, वैसे हम लोग BD का proof करेंगे. Okay? So we'll take these angles 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay? 5, 6, 7, 8. Now we'll start with ध्यान से देखो. AD is equals to AB sides of rhombus. So that will imply angle 5 and angle 6 are equal. Angles opposite to equal sides are equal. Okay. Now, angle 6 and angle 8 are also equal. Why?
Alternate interior angles.
Right, alternate interior angles. So, ध्यान से देखो, इन दोनों से हम लोग क्या conclude कर सकते हैं? Angle 5 is equals to angle 8. That means BD bisects angle B. Now, the next one. Angle 5 or angle 7 be equal है? Angle 5 or angle 7 by?
Alternate interior angles.
Right, alternate interior angles. So, in place of angle 5, we can write angle 6. Now, if these two angles are equal, that means BD bisects angle D. So, proof ho gaya pura? Any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. Now, the ninth question. Now, this is very important question. 5 marks question. In parallelogram ABCD, two points P and Q are taken on diagonal BD such that DP is equals to BQ. See this figure. Show that these two triangles are congruent. AP is equals to CQ. Triangle AQB is congruent to triangle CPD. And AQ is equals to CP. Last APCQ is a parallelogram. So let us start with the first one, these two triangles. कहां पर है? Are you able to identify?
Sir.
These two triangles. देखो यहां पर yellow color. Okay. So DP is equals to BQ. It is given. Next one. These two angles are equal. Why?
Alternate interior angles.
And AD is equals to BC. Why?
Opposite sides of parallelogram.
ठीक है? So therefore these two triangles are congruent by which criteria?
SAS criteria.
Very good. So now if these two triangles are congruent, AP is equals to CQ. Second one हो गया. CPCD. Right. Any doubt for in first and second bit?
No, sir.
Okay. Now third bit, we have to prove these two triangles congruent. ये वाला और ये वाला. ठीक है? तो third bit देखते हैं हम लोग. ये yellow color वाला. Now we'll start with first BQ is equals to DP. It is given. And these two angles are equal. Why?
Alternate interior angles.
Yes, alternate interior angles. And these two sides are equal. Why?
Opposite sides of parallelogram.
Very good. Opposite sides of parallelogram. So, jaldi se wo dekh lete hain hum log. So, these two triangles are congruent by which criteria?
SAS congruence rule.
Abhi fourth mein hum log ko proof karna tha AQ is equals to CP by CPCD.
CPCD.
Right. Abhi fifth mein hum log ko proof karna hai ki APCQ jo hai parallelogram hai. So that is also very easy. ध्यान से देखो, हम लोग proof कर चुके हैं AP is equals to CQ, already proved, and AQ is equals to CP, PC. This also we have proved. That means opposite sides of quadrilateral APCQ are equal, and we know that a quadrilateral is a parallelogram if its opposite sides are equal. So therefore APCQ is a parallelogram. Any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay, now 10th question. Now, this is also a very good question. ABCD is a parallelogram and AP and CQ are perpendiculars from vertex A and C on diagonal BD. Show that these two triangles are congruent and AP is equals to CQ. So, first of all, it is given that ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay? ये दोनों angles को मैं 1 or 2 ले लिया हूं. So AB is parallel to DC and BD being a transversal, so we can say that angle 1 is equals to angle 2. Why?
Alternate interior angles.
Now we are going to take these two triangles. Ye dono triangles ko le rahe hain. The green one. Okay. So let us start. Angle 1 is equals to angle 2. Already proved above, and AB is equals to CD. Why?
opposite sides of a parallelogram.
Very good. Opposite sides of parallelogram. And these two angles are equal. Why?
Each 90 degree.
Each 90 degree. So these two triangles are congruent by which criteria?
Angle side.
Very
angle
good. Side. AAS. So AP is equals to CQ by CPC.
CPC.
Right. So now we are moving toward the next question, 11th question. In triangle ABC and DEF, AB is equals to DE and AB is parallel to DE. BC is equals to EF and BC is parallel to EF. Vertices A, B, C are joined to vertices D, E, F respectively. Show that this quadrilateral is a parallelogram. Show that this quadrilateral is a parallelogram BEFC and AD is parallel to CF and AD is equals to CF. Quadrilateral ACFD is a parallelogram. Fifth, AC is equals to DF. Sixth bit. These two triangles are congruent. So let us start with the first one. In triangle ABC and triangle DEF, AB is equals to DE. Okay. And AB is parallel to DE also. In this quadrilateral, sorry. In this quadrilateral, AB is equals to DE and AB is parallel to DE. This is given. Okay. Clear hai?
Yes,
yes,
sir.
Yes, sir.
So now this parallelogram, this quadrilateral, one pair of opposite sides is equal and parallel. So therefore, ABED is a parallelogram. And this will imply AD is equals to BE and AD is parallel to BE. Why? Opposite sides of parallelogram are equal and parallel. So let it be equation number one. Now we have to show similarly. Hum log second wala proof kar sakte hai, ye wala BEFC. Isme dhyan se dekho, ye wala dono sides equal hai aur parallel hai. Right? Similarly, again in quadrilateral BEFC, BC is equals to EF and BC parallel to EF. So therefore, this quadrilateral, the green one, is a parallelogram. So if this is a parallelogram, CF is equals to BE and CF is parallel to BE. Why?
Opposite sides of parallelogram.
Right. Opposite sides of parallelogram are equal and parallel. Right. Let it be equation number 2. Now from equation 1 and 2. Dhyan se dekho, AD or BE parallel tha or CF or BE parallel hai. Or dono equal bhi hai. So from 1 and 2 we get AD parallel to CF and AD is equal to CF. Both are equal and parallel. So this will imply ACFD is a parallelogram. This one. Why? Because if one pair of opposite sides of a quadrilateral is equal and parallel, then it is a parallelogram. Hence, AC is equals to DF by why? AC and DF. Opposite sides of
parallelogram.
Yes.
Are equal and
parallel. Ab last mein hum log ko proof karna hai ye dono triangles ko congruent. So already it is given AB is equals to DE. Already it is given BC is equals to EF in the question and just now we have shown proof that AC is equals to DF. So these two triangles are congruent by which criteria?
SSS criteria.
Right. SSS congruence rule. Any doubt?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Now we are moving towards the next important theorem, midpoint theorem. Theorem 8.9. The line segment joining the midpoints of two sides of a triangle is parallel to third side and is half of it. This is very very important theorem क्योंकि बहुत सारे theorem में हम लोग इस property इस theorem का questions में इस theorem का use करेंगे. Okay, now see this question. A, B, C is a triangle and D and E are the midpoints of AB and AC respectively, right? And what we have to show that DE is parallel to BC. एंड डी ई इज हाफ ऑफ बी सी, ये प्रूफ करना है हम लोग को. ओके, तो सबसे पहले हम लोग एक कंस्ट्रक्शन कर लेते हैं. यहाँ पे सी एफ से एक पैरेलल लाइन ड्रॉ करेंगे, सी एफ पैरेलल टू बी ए, देन वी विल एक्सटेंड डी ई. ठीक है, पैरेलल लाइन ड्रॉ किए, फिर इसको एक्सटेंड कर रहे हैं, बोथ विल इंटरसेक्ट एट एफ. कंस्ट्रक्शन इज क्लियर?
यस सर.
ओके, नाउ वी विल प्रूव दिस टू ट्राइंगल्स कॉन्ग्रुएंट. फर्स्ट दिस टू ट्राइंगल्स येलो एंड ग्रीन कलर, ए ई इज इक्वल टू सी ए सी ई. वाई?
E is the midpoint of AC.
Very good. E is the midpoint of AC. And again, these two angles are equal. Why?
Vertically opposite angles.
Very good. And these two angles are equal. These two angles.
Alternate interior angles.
Right. Alternate interior angles. क्योंकि हम लोग यहाँ पे parallel line draw किए हैं. ठीक है? So these two triangles are congruent by which criteria?
Angle side angle.
Right, ASA. If you write by mistake AAS, then also it is correct. ठीक है? So यहाँ तक पहुँच गए हम लोग. Now AD is equals to CF and DE is equals to EF by CPCP. Right. So यहाँ तक clear है?
Yes sir.
But AD and BD both are equal. Why?
D is the midpoint,
is
of,
the midpoint
AB.
Of AB.
Very good. Because D is the midpoint of AB. तो ये दोनों भी इक्वल हो जाएगा, BD और CF. And दोनों पैरेलल भी है. Right? So one pair of opposite sides equal भी है और पैरेलल भी है. तो ये क्या हो जाएगा, B, C, F, D is a parallelogram. Whether this is clear?
Yes, yes, sir.
Because if one pair of opposite sides of a quadrilateral is parallel and equal, then it is a parallelogram. Right. So that means DF is parallel to BC and DF is equals to BC, opposite sides of parallelogram. DF or DE, dono same line hai, DE or DF. So that means in place of DF, we can write DE also. Okay. And DF, we can write two times of DE. Why? Because these two are equal. Or half of DF is equals to half of BC, that is equals to DE. Why? Because DE is equals to EF. We proved above. Whether this is clear?
Yes, sir.
DE और EF दोनों इक्वल है ना, तो DE जो है वो DF का हाफ हो जाएगा. DE जो है DF का हाफ हो जाएगा. इन प्लेस ऑफ DF वी कैन राइट BC. ओके, बिकॉज बोथ आर इक्वल. सो हेंस DE इज पैरेलल टू BC एंड DE इज हाफ ऑफ BC. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट एक्सरसाइज 8.2, सम सेलेक्टेड क्वेश्चन. सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन एंड दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. ABCD इज अ क्वाड्रिलैटरल in which P, Q, R and S are the midpoints of the side AB, BC, CD and DA. AC is the diagonal. Show that first SR parallel to AC and SR is half of AC. Second, PQ is equals to SR and the third one is PQRS is a parallelogram. Okay. So first we will take this triangle ACD. Dhyan se dekho, this triangle. S is the midpoint of AD and R is the midpoint of CD. Okay, so by midpoint theorem, SR is equals to half of AC and SR is parallel to AC. Any doubt here? So let it be equation number one. Similarly, now we are going to take ABC triangle. P is the midpoint of AB and Q is the midpoint of BC. So by midpoint theorem, PQ is parallel to AC and PQ is half of AC, right? So let it be equation number 2. So from equation 1 and 2, dhyan se dekho, SR is also half of AC and PQ is also half of AC. So that means PQ and SR are equal. So this is second bit. Okay, now PQ is equals to SR and PQ is also parallel to SR. How? क्योंकि अभी प्रूफ किए हैं PQ parallel to AC and SR parallel to AC. And we know that the two lines parallel to the same line are to the given line are parallel to each other. So that means PQ is parallel to SR. So one pair of opposite sides is parallel and equal. So therefore PQRS is a parallelogram. Why? Because if one pair of opposite sides of a quadrilateral is equal and parallel, then it is a parallelogram. Any doubt in this question?
No, no sir.
No, sir. Okay.
Now the second question. ABCD is a rhombus and PQRS are the midpoints of the side AB, BC, CD and DA respectively. Show that quadrilateral PQRS is a rectangle. See this second question, third question and fourth question, these are all 5 marks questions. ओके रेक्टेंगल के लिए हम लोग को क्या प्रूफ करना है फर्स्ट पी क्यू आर एस पैरेललोग्राम है सेकंड वन एंगल इज 90 डिग्री ओके पैरेललोग्राम का जो स्टेप्स है बिल्कुल सेम है जो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन में किए थे सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद दैट वन सो फर्स्ट वी विल ड्रॉ ए सी डायगोनल नाउ इन दिस ट्राइंगल ए बी सी पी इज द मिड पॉइंट ऑफ ए बी एंड क्यू इज द मिड पॉइंट ऑफ बी सी So PQ is parallel to AC and PQ is half of AC by midpoint theorem. Let it be equation number one. Similarly, in this triangle, the green one, S is the midpoint of AD and R is the midpoint of CD. So by midpoint theorem, SR is parallel to AC and SR is half of AC. Let it be second equation. Now from equation one and two, we conclude that PQ is parallel to SR and PQ is equals to SR, right? So therefore PQRS is a parallelogram. Why? Because one pair of opposite sides is equal and parallel. Any doubt here?
No, sir.
Okay. Now our target is to prove one angle is 90 degree. So उसके लिए थोड़ा सा exercise करना पड़ेगा. We will take diagonal BD also. Diagonal BD and we know that diagonals of rhombus bisect at 90 degree. The answer dekho BD. Diagonals of rhombus bisect each other right angle. So what is the value of this angle? EOF. 90 degree?
90 degree.
Right. Okay. Now we'll take in triangle BCD. The answer dekho BCD. This yellow color. R is the midpoint of CD and Q is the midpoint of CB. So by midpoint theorem, RQ is parallel to DB and half of DB. But we will take only RQ parallel to DB. And in place of RQ, we can write RE because it belongs to same line. In place of DB, we can write FO. Clear? And SR parallel to AC will imply FR parallel to, the answer dekho, FR parallel to OE. Now in this quadrilateral, opposite sides are parallel to each other. So we can write that OERF is a parallelogram. Any doubt? So these two angles are equal. These two angles are equal. Why? Opposite angles
of a parallelogram.
Parallelogram. Very good. But this angle is 90 degree. So this angle is also 90 degree. Okay. So यहाँ पे हम लोग क्या लिख सकते हैं PQRS में एंगल R जो है वो 90 degree हो गया PQRS is a parallelogram with angle R is equals to 90 degree. So therefore PQRS is a rectangle. Any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. Next question. This is also 5 marks question. ABCD is a rectangle and PQRS are the midpoints of the sides AB, BC, CD and DA respectively. Show that this is a rhombus, PQRS. So rhombus proof karne ke liye kya kya proof karna padega? First parallelogram, then all sides are equal. सो पैरेललोग्राम प्रूफ करने के लिए वही सेम स्टेप है जो अभी पिछले क्वेश्चन में किए थे. सी दिस ट्राइंगल पी एंड क्यू आर द मिड पॉइंट्स ऑफ ए बी एंड बी सी रेस्पेक्टिवली. सो देयरफॉर बाय मिड पॉइंट थ्योरम पी क्यू इज पैरेलल टू ए सी एंड पी क्यू इज हाफ ऑफ ए सी. ओके एंड वी विल टेक नाउ दिस ट्राइंगल द ग्रीन वन. एस इज द मिड पॉइंट ऑफ ए डी, R is the midpoint of CD, so by midpoint theorem, SR is parallel to AC and half of it. And from equation 1 and 2, PQ is parallel to SR and PQ is equals to SR. So this will imply PQRS is a parallelogram because one pair of opposite sides is equal and parallel. ये बिल्कुल copy है पिछले question का, ठीक है? Now parallelogram के बाद आप लोगों को proof करना है all sides are equal. So let us start. So first ABCD is a rectangle, so AD is equals to BC. Okay, so half of AD is equals to half of BC. What is half of AD? We can write AS, and half of BC we can write BQ. Any doubt?
No sir.
Okay, अब हम लोग ये दोनों triangles को congruent proof करेंगे. ध्यान से देखो. ये दोनों ग्रीन और येलो ये तो ऑलरेडी प्रूफ कर चुके हैं. ए एस इज इक्वल्स टू बी क्यू. नाउ ए पी इज इक्वल्स टू बी पी. व्हाई?
पी इज द मिड पॉइंट ऑफ ए बी.
वेरी गुड. एंड दिस टू एंगल्स आर इक्वल. व्हाई?
ईच 90 डिग्री.
वेरी गुड. बिकॉज इट इज अ रेक्टेंगल ए बी सी डी, सो ईच 90 डिग्री. सो दिस टू ट्रायंगल्स आर कॉन्ग्रुएंट बाय विच क्राइटेरिया?
एस एस
क्राइटेरिया. वेरी गुड. एस एस क्राइटेरिया. ओके, so if these two triangles are congruent, so PS is equals to PQ. Why?
CPCT.
CPCT, right? But PS is equals to QR and PQ is equals to SR. Why?
Opposite sides of a parallelogram.
Very good. Opposite sides of parallelogram. अब इसमें already हम लोग ये दोनों equal prove कर चुके हैं. So all sides are equal. Hence PQRS is a rhombus. Any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay, so now we are moving towards question number 5. In a parallelogram ABCD, E and F are the midpoints of side AB and CD respectively. Show that the line segment AF and EC trisects the diagonal BD. Trisect means three equal parts. मतलब हम लोगों को क्या प्रूफ करना है? ये, ये और ये equal है प्रूफ करना है. ठीक है? So let us start. First, BD be intersected by CE and AF at Q and P respectively. This is already given. Now AB parallel to DC and AB is equals to DC. Opposite sides of parallelogram. Okay. So ध्यान से देखो. AB parallel AB की जगह पे हम लोग AE लिख सकते हैं और DC की जगह पे हम लोग FC लिख सकते हैं. And half of AB will be equals to half of DC. What you can write in place of half of AB? AE.
AE.
In place of half of DC?
FC. CF.
Right. So now one pair of opposite sides is equal and parallel. So ये जो quadrilateral दिख रहा है, the yellow color का, this is a parallelogram. Why? Because if one pair of opposite sides of quadrilateral is equal and parallel, it is a parallelogram. So that means AF is parallel to EC. ध्यान से देखो, AF is parallel to EC. Why? Opposite sides of parallelogram are parallel. So EQ जो है, ध्यान से देखो, EQ. EQ is parallel to AP. Clear? And FP is parallel to CQ. So, हम लोग अब ये ट्राइंगल एक एक बार लेंगे. ये वाला ट्राइंगल और ये वाला ट्राइंगल वन बाय वन लेंगे. चलो, वेदर दिस इज क्लियर? ये वाला स्टेप. ओके, नाउ इन ट्राइंगल बी ए पी, दिस ट्राइंगल बी ए पी, ई इज द मिड पॉइंट ऑफ ए बी, इट इज गिवन एंड दिस इज पैरेलल टू दिस वन, ऑलरेडी प्रूव्ड. So converse of midpoint theorem, Q is the midpoint of BP. midpoint of BP means BQ is equals to PQ. ये क्लियर है?
Yes sir.
Okay, now we'll take this triangle. ध्यान से देखो, F is the midpoint of DC and these two lines are parallel. So P is the midpoint of DQ हो जाएगा by converse of midpoint theorem. So DP is equals to PQ. If we combine these two, then all three sides are equal. यही proof करना था हम लोग को. Hence CE and AF trisects the diagonal BD. Any doubt?
Awesome.
Okay. So now we are moving towards question number 6. Show that the line segments joining the midpoints of the opposite sides of a quadrilateral bisect each other. देखो PR और SQ को हम लोग join किए, ये दोनों एक दूसरे को bisect कर रहा है, ये proof करना है. So ये बहुत easy है. हम लोग क्या करेंगे, पहले join करेंगे PQ और RQ, RS और ये सब ज्वाइन करेंगे. ठीक है, देखो ज्वाइन कर लिए और एसी को ज्वाइन कर लिए. नाउ इन ट्राइंगल ए बी सी, पहले हम लोग पी क्यू आर एस को पैरेललोग्राम प्रूफ करेंगे जो हम लोग पिछले क्वेश्चंस में किए थे, बिल्कुल कॉपी. इन ट्राइंगल ए बी सी, दिस वन पी इज द मिड पॉइंट ऑफ ए बी एंड क्यू इज द मिड पॉइंट ऑफ सी बी. सो पी क्यू इज पैरेलल टू ए सी एंड हाफ ऑफ ए सी. लेट इट बी क्वेश्चन नंबर वन. Now we'll take this triangle ADC. S is the midpoint of AD and R is the midpoint of CD. So SR is equals to half of AC and SR is parallel to AC. And from equation 1 and 2, PQ is parallel to SR and PQ is equals to SR. So PQRS is a parallelogram because in quadrilateral PQRS, one pair of opposite sides are parallel and equal. Up, ye PRQS इस पैरेललोग्राम का क्या है? डायगनल. एंड वी नो दैट डायगनल्स ऑफ पैरेललोग्राम बाइसेक्ट ईच अदर. सो देयरफॉर डायगनल्स PR एंड QS बाइसेक्ट ईच अदर एट पॉइंट O. सो दिस इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 6. नाउ वी आर मूविंग टुवर्ड्स द लास्ट क्वेश्चन. ओके, क्वेश्चन नंबर 7. ABC इज अ ट्राइंगल right angle at C. A line through the midpoint M of hypotenuse AB and parallel to BC intersect AC at D. Show that D is the midpoint of AC, MD is parallel to AC and CM is equals to MA is equals to half of AB. So this is also 5 marks question and very important question. So let us start with the first. In triangle ABC, M is the midpoint of AB and MD is parallel to BD, BC it is given. Okay, so therefore D is the midpoint of AC. Why? By converse of midpoint theorem. Right, so ye ho gaya first wala. Second, MD perpendicular to AC. To uske liye ye wala jo line hai wo BC ke parallel hai. L is parallel to BC, it is given, and this is 90 degree. Okay, this is 90 degree, it is given. Angle 1 is equals to angle C. Why these two angles are equal? Corresponding angles. Okay, and angle C jab 90 degree hai, to angle 1 bhi 90 degree hoga. If angle 1 is 90 degree, so MD is perpendicular to AC. Okay, next, third one. Now we are going to prove these two triangles congruent. Kaun kaun sa? Ye dono, yellow or green wala, AMD or CMD. Dhyan se dekho, these two sides are equal. Why?
Proved above.
Right. Okay, fine. Proved above. And angle 1 is equals to angle 2.
Each 90 degree
and MD is common. So these two triangles are congruent by which criteria? SAS, right. Okay, so SAS se congruent ho gaya. Now these two sides are also equal. AM is equals to CM. Yes, very good. CPCT. नाउ एम को हम लोग लिख सकते हैं हाफ ऑफ ए बी, वाई
एम इज द मिड पॉइंट ऑफ ए बी.
वेरी गुड, गिवन दैट एम इज द मिड पॉइंट ऑफ ए बी, सो ए एम वी कैन राइट हाफ ऑफ ए बी, एंड इन प्लेस ऑफ ए एम वी कैन राइट सी एम बिकॉज दिस टू आर इक्वल. सो फ्रॉम वन एंड टू वी गेट ए एम इज इक्वल टू सी एम इज इक्वल टू हाफ ऑफ ए बी. एनी डाउट? ओके, नाउ वी आर मूविंग टूवर्ड्स द लास्ट सेक्शन, दैट इज असाइनमेंट क्वेश्चन. ओनली टू क्वेश्चन आर देयर. सो दैट्स ऑल फॉर टूडे सेशन. थैंक यू वेरी मच.